हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
हैव यू सीन द लेक्चर दैट आई हैव अपलोडेड यस्टरडे? बिकॉज एक्चुअली वी आर हैविंग अ पास सिलेबस एंड ओनली रिमेनिंग विथ 1 month, सो एवरी संडे मे बी आई विल गिव यू वन रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर, सो दैट ऑन संडे एटलीस्ट वेन एवर यू गेट द टाइम यू कैन सी दैट लेक्चर। सो आई होप ओनली 24 व्यूज वॉज देयर फॉर दैट लेक्चर, सो ओनली 24 स्टूडेंट हैज सीन दिस। Am I right or not? See, to complete the syllabus, that's why I'm taking a lecture on a Sunday. This Sunday, I have taken only 1 hour lecture. But from the next Sunday onwards, I will take at least 2 hour lecture. So, depending on that, on Sunday, at least whenever you are actually on Sunday, I want to take a live lecture. But as it is a Sunday, so you might be having some different work. So that's why I have decided to put a one recorded lecture every Sunday. From next Sunday onwards, I will put a lecture of at least 2 hours so that our syllabus will be completed earlier and you can appear for the exam with the nice preparations. Okay. So be prepared with that every Sunday you have to see a lecture. After at least general topology, because my syllabus is vast. So how many of you have seen the lecture? See, why I'm putting a recorded lecture on Sunday? Because maybe some of you having some maybe going somewhere else, and also depending on your time itself, you can see the lecture. Okay. Okay, let us go for the next one. Some of the properties and some of the examples, and I think some of the theorems also I have shown you in the last lecture, which was a recorded lecture. So now let me go for the next theorem. Okay, we are provided that X2 be a topological space. This statement I have written already in the last lecture. E space, let X star O star be its subspace. Let X star O star be its subspace. So what do you mean by subspace? We should know what is a relative topology if I want to discuss about a subspace. Okay, so we are having one subset F star of X star such that what is our aim to prove? F star is closed if and only if F star is closed if and only if F star is equals to X star intersection with F, where F is a closed set in X2, a closed set in X2, right? Where F star is a closed set. Depending on this F star will be a closed set only if your F is a closed set in X. Okay, F star is a closed set in X star to star if and only if X is a F is a closed set in X2. What is X star? X star is any subset of a X. Okay, by using related topologies. Now, I think you are knowing what is a related topology in the initial lectures we have seen. After the definition of topology and some examples, we have defined the related topology by tau star is equals to star, the intersection with star condition is the open set from X2. Okay, what is your X star? X star is any subset of a X, and that is called a related topology, right? So we are provided that X star to star is a it's a subspace, and what is the next condition given to us is F star is a subset of X star. That is, F star is provided to us any subset of a X star, right? So depending on this definition of a related topology, we can say is we can define G star. What is a G star? G intersection with X star, right? What is a G star? G star is a member of a टू स्टार ऑन द कंडीशन जी इज अ मेंबर ऑफ अ टू. आठवते ना सगळ्यांना रिलेटिव टोपोलॉजी? हॅलो, एम आय ऑडिबल?
यस मॅम.
सो I think this I have told you in the last recorded lecture that you should go for the definition of relative topology if you want to understand this theorem, right? So what is this relative topology? It is defined with the help of a members of two, and that is open set intersection with that set, okay? X star intersection with open set, okay? From where you are going to collect this open set from topology two, right? So this G star is a member of two star if and only if G is a member of a two. Now this we have proved for a open set. The same thing in this theorem we have to prove for a closed set. Okay, instead of G star we have a F star, right? Instead of G we have a F. Okay, already apan prove kele na aplya related topology madhe, right? So this is with the help of a definition of a related topology, or we can say it is a subspace topology. Now we know this thing, that is we know the definition of a relative topology. Now as we want to prove this in the two part, let us start with the only if part. What is there in the only if part? We have been provided that F star is a closed set in X star two star, right? F star is a closed set in X star two star, just like your G star. G star is open set in two star if and only if G is a open set in X two, on the condition G star is written as G intersection with X star. So related topology is the name itself suggested that it is related to your X star, right? X star is any subset of X. The name itself suggests that we have to take an intersection of X star with every member of a two, and the new topology whatever we are going to generate is a related topology or the subspace topology. Now we know one theorem. What the theorem tells us? If X star is a closed set in X2, then can I write this as X star minus F star is open set in X star two star? Am I right? By the theorem, what the theorem related to this is, we are having, let F be a closed set, then F complement is open set. We have proved this theorem, na?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so with the help of that theorem, you can write the statement of the theorem here that F is a closed set if and only F star is a F complement is a open set. So in the very similar way, instead of writing F complement, you can write this as X star minus F star, or you can write F star complement is a open set. As it is a open set, it must be a member of a two star. So if it is a member of a two star, how I am writing the members of two star in star with this? We are writing them as, yes, how we can write? X star intersection with some open set G, na? Yes or no? Because what is F star complement? It is an open set. So every open set from subspace topology or related topology, how you are writing every member of a two star, we are writing with the G intersection with X star. Okay, X star is fixed out, intersection with G we are going to take, right? Agar F star closed set hai, toh F star its complement will be open set. And we know two star, how two star is defined? It is a related topology. It is defined by G intersection with X star. Okay, members of two intersection with X star, right? So as it is a open set, this can be written in the form of G intersection with X star. Okay, any doubt up to this one?
No ma'am.
Now the same set, whatever I have written here, X star minus F star is equal to, can I write this as X star minus X star intersection with G? F complement hai na, F star complement. F star complement can be written as X star minus F star, right? So this is what, X star minus X star intersection with G. Can I write this step?
Yes ma'am.
How can anyone explain me this one? और इज इट करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट? यहाँ पे हमने सिर्फ जी इंटरसेक्शन एक्स स्टार लिखा है, हमें नेक्स्ट स्टेप कैन आई इंक्लूड दिस वन और वेदर इट इज अ ट्रू स्टेटमेंट इज रॉन्ग ना? ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट द एक्चुअली स्टेटमेंट इज. We have the statement as F star complement. This F star complement, I can write it as X star minus F star is equal to G intersection with X star, right? So if I take X star complement again, because we know that complement of a complement is a set itself. Yes, I can write this as F star is equal to X star minus G intersection with X star. Okay, is it okay now? Just taking the complement on both side with X star, right? If I take a complement on both side once again with X star, I can write this as X star minus X star minus. So this will be minus minus become plus, and hence I will remain with only F star. Okay. Now, this statement I can write it as X intersection with X star minus G intersection with X star. Why this is so? Because we know that what we know is X star is a subset of X. Okay. A set with its a superset. What is the intersection? It is a subset itself, na? A set with its a subset, a set with its a superset. So whatever may be smaller one, that will be the intersection. So this statement I can write it as X intersection with X star, since your X is a superset. So intersection of superset with its a subset is a your set itself, right? X star. Okay. So now this statement from these two, this X star I can take common, right? So if I take the X star common from both, so for this you must be going with the 12th standard notebooks in which we are having the operations of intersection, complement, union, so that you can understand this one. If I X star, if I have taken common, the intersection is common in both the things. So what is remaining here? We are remaining with X, and this minus sign will be remaining, and from this bracket we are remaining with G. Okay, so if G is open set, we have selected, right? Why G is open set we have selected? From this statement, since F star is a closed set, its complement must be open set. So every open set from two star relative topology definition, we can write it as open set intersection with X star. So G a open set hai already, right? So if G is open set, what must be X minus G? आहेत का सगळे का झोपले? हॅलो.
यस मॅम.
यस मॅम.
एक्स स्टार इंटरसेक्शन विथ एक्स मायनस जी. व्हॉट इज जी? जी इज अ ओपन सेट. सो ओपन सेट का कॉम्प्लिमेंट क्या आएगा? इट इज विल बी सिंपली अ क्लोज सेट विच वी आर डिनोटिंग बाय एफ. सो एफ विल बी इक्वल टू X star intersection with F, and hence the proof. So first part we have proved. So how to start with this? First, what we given in the first part, X star is a closed set. But we know the theorem that if any set is a closed set, its complement is a open set. By using that concept, we have to say that F star complement is a member of a two star. So by using the definition of a relative topology, we have to take up one open set. An open set intersection with X star will give you F star complement. Just take the complement once again, and then you can get the result. And simply take the intersection of X with X star. Why this step is important? Then only you can take X star common, right? So X intersection with X star. If suppose A is a subset of B, so what will be A intersection B? It is obviously A, right? Common elements, huh? So X star, if I take common, intersection, if I have taken common, so we are remaining with X minus, that is complement, you can say G. And what is a complement of G? G is a open set in X2, so complement of G is a closed set F. Okay, so hence we have proved the first part. Now let us go for the second part. What is there in the if part? In the if part, we have been provided that f star is equal to x star intersection f is, it is given to us this one, from closed set f. F is a closed set from family K. And what is our aim to prove that? Our aim is to prove that f star is a closed set. Right? Initially, we are having f star is a closed set was our claim. Now here in this part, we have to prove f star is a closed set in x star closed star. So that is to prove that, as we are in case of a topology. So instead of proving any set to be a closed set, it is easy for us to prove any set to be an open set. So if I want to prove f star to be closed set, I can prove x star minus f star is a open set. Yes, whether these two statements are equivalent? Hello, आहेत का आज सगळे? संडेचा हँगओव्हर गेला नाही का?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have x star minus f star. So if I want to prove f star to be a closed set, I can prove x star minus f star is a open. To prove this one, what I have to start with, I will start with this as x star minus. What is f star given to us? In the second part, we have been provided with this statement. If this statement is x star minus f, okay? X star intersection f, where f is a taken from the family of a closed set in x2. So whatever the statement given in the if part, we have to take this. This will be f star is nothing but x star intersection with f, on the condition f is a closed set from the family x2. Okay, now again, we have to take a help of same statement. What is a statement? X star is a subset of X. So that's why intersection of a superset with its subset is an intersection, the subset itself. So that's why I'm writing the same statement once again. Now, again, we have to take X star common. So what I remains with, we are remaining with X in this one, minus F, right? Now, what is given to us? We have been provided that this statement is true on the condition f is a closed set from family K. Okay, or we can say f is a closed set in X2. If f is a closed set, what must be x minus f? Or you can say f complement. Why I'm using, up to now we were using f complement as a notation for complement. But now I'm using it as x minus f so that you can be familiar with all type of notations, because many times in the different exams, if you have to appear for certain date exam or any exam, so the notations are somewhat confusing. So you may go for the notes of Shivaji University or KP Gupta. In that, the notation for complement is not this one. They are using it as x minus f. So that's why in this theorem, I am using these notations, so that you can be familiar with all type of notation. If f is a closed set, x minus f, that is f complement will be open set, that I can denote by open set G. So where, from where we have started with x star minus f star, right? So we have started with x star minus f star, and we reach to G intersection x star. Again, we have to make a use of a relative topology, which we have studied in the initial lectures, where we have defined the topology. So G open set intersection with x star is a G star. Okay, what is a G star? G star is a open set from toe star, right? So hence we have proved if this is a open set, obviously it will be also a open set. So it means that if this is a open set, it means f star is a closed set. Okay, so in this way you have to prove the result. In both the ways you have to go by same conditions, but what is a change only in the first one we have to prove S star is a closed set, but here in this, in the first one we have to prove F star is equal to X star intersection F, where F is a closed set. In the second part we have to prove F star is a closed set, but every time we have to use this condition only. Okay, इसके through ही आपको prove करना है. Okay, any doubt for this one? Okay, let me define some of the corollaries with the help of this. What is C star F star? I am using the notation C star now for the closure of the set, right? Many times in the different books, the notation for closure is used as CLF, or it is it is denoted as F bar, or it is written as CF. Okay, CF means closure of F. CL means again closure of F. F its bar, it will be also a closure of F, right? So what will be C star F star? It is closure of F star related to what in X star to star, right? Now what will be C F star? It is closure of F star in X2, right? Because C is written here, it is not C star. So C star रहेगा तो वो क्या होगा? Closure in X star to star. But if it is simply C, then it is a closure of F star in X2. Okay, X2 is a what your superset, or you can say just like our group and subgroup. X star to star is a subgroup and X2 is a group itself, right? So these are what the simply notations used for the closure of the set. Okay, and I want to give you one remark that C star of F star is always equals to C of F star, that is closure of any set in the relative topology or in the superset topology. In both the ways the closure is equal. Okay, whether you are in the subset topology or you are in the X2 itself, the closure of any set is remaining the set same, but rather your condition should be what? F star must be your from your X star to star. Okay, जो भी आपका subspace topology में से अगर आप कोई set लेते हो, right? So if you want to find out closure of that set, that closure of the set in both the cases, either it is in subset or in the original X2. So in both the case, the closure is same. Okay. Yes, if you are having any doubt, you can ask. Yes, if you are not having a doubt, let me go for the next definition, that is basis and subbasis. It is not basis, actually it is basis and subbasis. Okay, I hope you are knowing what is basis. Basis might be a sagda now. Let me write down the definition of base. Why I'm writing basis? Because they are not unique, just like our basic. Suppose you want to have a R3 over R, right? Many bases are exist for this R3 over R. The standard one is 100, 010, and 001. There are so many ordered bases are also there. So that's why it is called a basis, because they are not unique one. So base is also not a unique one, and we are having subbases also. So let me define firstly what is base. Let X to be a topological space, and let B, that is family B, is called base, which is a subset of to, right? Is said to be a base. Is said to be base. Okay, this family B is called a base for topology to, or to topology to on X. If each member of to, if each member of to can be expressed as union of some members of B. Okay, we have started with let X to be a T space. What is the condition? B is must be a subset of to. What was the definition of to? Let me remember the definition of to. Initially, we should have to must be a subset of power set of X, and it must satisfy that 3 to 4 conditions. Okay, X and to must be a member of X and empty set, that is phi must be a member of to, then it must be closed under intersection, it must be closed under arbitrary union. Okay, I hope everyone knowing this. What was the condition? To must be a subset of power set X. Now here, what is the condition? That the family B should be a subset of a topology to, and this to is a topology on X. This will be condition true only if every member of to can be expressed as union of some members of B, right? Every member of a to, if you take any member of to, suppose it is A, so every member of a to must be expressed as union of members of B. Suppose I have taken BI from your family B, and suppose I have taken A from to, so every member of to should be written as union of members of BI. If this condition holds, so we can say that B beta or B is a base for our topology. Okay, what is the condition? Only every member of to should be written as union of some members of B, then it is called a base. Okay, in another way, there is another definition, just like we are having the two definitions for our limit point. I have given you a homework also, that you have to see the proof that definition one implies definition two, or definition two implies an implied one, right? For limit point, we are having the two condition. Either we are saying that interval should contain at least one point other than zeta, or in another way, we can say that that neighborhood should contain infinitely many points other than zeta, right? So it is having one-one correspondence, or we can say that the two definitions are equivalent. The proof of this is available in the mathematical analysis, S.C. Malik Shepita Valdora book. And here also we are having the two definitions for the base. Okay, that I will show you with the proof that how the two definitions are equivalent. Okay, initially again in this definition also we have been provided with X2 is a topological space. Okay, and what is again condition? B must be a subset of a to, then B is called a base for topology to, B is called base for topology to on capital S. If for X belongs to G, G belongs to to, there should exist one member from family B which satisfy the condition. What you can say it is such that X must be a member of B and B must be contained in the G. Okay. Now, what was the initial definition? We have to say that every member of two should be written as union of some members of B. Right? BIs are the members of B and A is a member of two. So, every member of two should be written as union of some members of B. Okay. So now in the second definition, we have been provided that again the first condition is same, that is B is a subset of two, but the second condition is what? If this condition is there, right? Or in another way, in the initial definition, what was in the definition? First definition mein kya tha? If you are having any member of two, just like this, if G is a member of two, every member of two should be written as union of some members of B. So here also we have taken one member from topology two on the condition with the help of some element, ensuring that you are having non-empty open set, right? X is a member of G, G is a member of a two. Okay, in the very similar way of a first definition, we have taken one element from a two. And what is there in the first definition? Every member of two should be written as union of some members of B. But here it is given that if this condition holds, we should have. This is what if and then. So what should have? We should have at least one element or at least one member of B in such a way that X should be contained in that B, B is contained in G, right? So from here also you can see that the definition one will be required because written as union of subset relation is there. Now this is only for one element. The D element of G, if I am having these type of a B. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is what only for one element. That means if X is a member of G, G is a member of two. Just like our first definition. What is our first definition? Every member of two is written as union of some members of B. These BIs are members of B. And this G is a member of a two. So here also, if I take a union on both sides, I can say that G can be written as union of some members of B. Right? No, because G is what? G we have written with the help of X belongs to B, D is contained in G. And this B is only related to that your element X. And if you are going to collect such number of B, you can say that you are G. What is G? G is a member of a two. Can be written as union of members of B. Okay? Is that clear how the two statements or the two definitions are equivalent? And you can go vice versa. That is, this definition you can imply the next one. That is, every member of two can be written as union of members of B. So here also this definition you can written for a single element. Okay, here we have taken the element from two or the member of two. Instead of taking member of two, you can take an element and the same definition, that is say definition two will be equal. Okay, so have you understood what is a base topology? In short, you can simply remember that every member of two should be written as union of some members of B. Or if someone asks you about the second definition, you can say that if X is a member of G, G is a member of 2, then there should exist one B which contain X and which is contained in the G. And if you take a union on both sides, you can imply to the second first definition. That is, every member of G can be written as union of members of B. What is B? B is a base, and B is a base. First condition for being a base is a it must be a subset of a topology two. And what is two? Two must be a subset of power set of X. Okay. Now let me go over one example. You can also write with me what is the example of base. Let X is equals to A, B, C. 2 is equals to 5X, A, B. A, B, C. And 2 is equals to 5 singleton A, B, and C. Okay, you have to verify that whether every member of 2 can be written as union of members of B. If I take 5, 5 can be written as union of 5. If I take X, X can be written as union of A, B, and C. It will give you X. Barabar? So if I take the next one, AB. If I combine these two, it will give you AB. Singleton A can be written as union of singleton A. B can be written as union of singleton B. You can write B as a union of singleton B. Because singleton element ke liye kuch problem hai na. Every member of 2 can be written as union of members of B. It is not having a condition that we should have a union mein ek se zyada element chahiye, right? Union can have at least one element. This C can be written as C itself, singleton C. Can be written as union of singleton C. This is a member of B and this is what a member of a 2. So this BC, I can write the by taking the union of singleton B and C. So now you can see that this B is a base. But first you should verify whether B is a subset of 2. Aheka B subset of 2.
Yes, ma'am.
A, singleton B, singleton C. So hence it is a subset. And by verifying the condition that every member of 2 can be written as union of members of B. Or in you can go for the second condition that if I want to verify for singleton A. Right? If I want to go for the open set from 2, I am writing for singleton A. For singleton A, what must be condition? If X is a member of A, instead of A, it is A. A is a member of singleton A. So in the very similar way, X is a member of G. So what we should have? We should have X must be a member of B. B is contained in G. So you can write it as A is member of singleton A, and this singleton A is contained in singleton A itself. Or you can write it as can be here. What is the condition? X must be member of B. B is contained in G. Okay. So here this is a member of 2, and this is what we have taken a member from B. So you can verify for every element. If I take any element, say C, so for every element I have to do this. So if C is a member of a, if I want to write it as BC, okay. Just like this definition. What is the definition? X is a member of a G. And what is the condition? X belongs to B, B is contained in G. So in the very similar way, I can write C is belonging to B. One open set we have to take. This I can say it is a singleton C, sorry. Member of B I have to take, and which is contained in G. What is your G? BC. Okay. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
एग्जाम डिक्लेअर झाले का तुमचे? नाही ना? Why you are so silent today? Let us go for the second example. What is there in the second example? 2u is equals to, we are having a usual topological space. We have proved the usual topological space. For every element A from capital A, we should have an open interval, right? We should have r greater than 0 such that A minus r, A plus r must be contained in A, right? Now, for this one, I will define different bases and you have to verify whether they are a basis or not. Okay, you have to say that whether B1 is a base or not, so that I can understand whether actually you have got it, the definition or not. Let me define B2, AB in such a way that open interval AB and A and B are members of Q. B3 if I have taken A to infinity, I have taken A from real number. And if I have another base, say B4, which is from minus infinity to B, on the condition if I have taken B from real number. Okay. So this is what a usual topological space you are knowing, and these are four bases, right? Usual topology mahiti asa kada na? Abhyas chalu hai now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here B1, B2, B3, B4 are the four sub-bases I have, bases I have given you. You have to verify whether these are actually bases for topology or not. Okay. Try to solve this and tell me whether they are bases or not. So this is what a topology and these are the bases. Try to think and try to solve it so that I can be sure that whether you understood this or not. Are you getting whether P1 is a base or not? Yes, okay, just tell me what is the nature of members of toe? टो के मेंबर्स कैसे दिखते हैं आपके ओपन इंटरवल के टाइप में ना. सो वी शुड हैव ए इज अ मेंबर ऑफ टो इफ एंड ओनली इफ देयर एग्जिस्ट एन ओपन इंटरवल व्हिच कंटेन्स दैट ए एंड व्हिच इज कंटेन्ड इन कैपिटल ए. राइट नाउ व्हाट इज अ कंडीशन. एवरी मेंबर ऑफ टो शुड बी रिटन एज यूनियन ऑफ मेंबर्स ऑफ बी. इन द फर्स्ट केस इट इज बी1. नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो ओपन इंटरवल. फर्स्ट केस बी1, बी1 इज हैविंग द ओपन इंटरवल ए बी. So I can write capital A with the help of open interval AB since A and B are members of R, real line pair, na? Because your usual topology is defined with the help of a real line itself, right? No?
Yes, ma'am.
So I can say that suppose usual topology is what related to your real line, right? Suppose A is some set from your topology to O. So this some set can be written as union of members of B1. Okay, B1 ke members kaise open interval ke type mein na? Where A and B are real numbers. So if A and B are the real numbers, I can write this capital A from your topology as union of members of B, right? I can take a smaller interval. I can take A and B as a real number and I can write A as a itself A, because if A is a open interval, agar wo open interval hai, so it is okay. Or in another way, you can write it as union of open intervals, right? Because actual definition of A, we have written with the help of A minus, what is the condition? A minus R, A plus R should be contained in A for every A belongs to A, right? For every element of capital A, we should have an open interval which is contained in capital A. So already यहाँ पे हमने open interval create किया है, right? For every element of A, right? So for every element of capital A, where A is a member of O, if we have already created open interval in the topology itself, so we can select them as union of members of B, right? इसको ही हम बी का मेंबर सिलेक्ट कर सकते हैं ना. और वी कैन से इट इज अ मेंबर ऑफ अ बी1, बिकॉज व्हाट इज बी1. बी1 इज सिंपली विद द हेल्प ऑफ ओपन इंटरवल ए बी ऑन द कंडीशन ए एंड बी आर अ मेंबर्स ऑफ आर, राइट? सिंपली ओपन इंटरवल है वेयर ए एंड बी आर अ रियल नंबर. सो वी कैन से दैट ए कैन बी नाउ रिटन एज यूनियन ऑफ मेंबर्स ऑफ ओपन इंटरवल ए बी एंड हेंस आई कैन से बी1 इज अ बेस. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
In the very similar way, I can do it for rational number. Instead of having a real number, I can do it for rational number also. Even for a to infinity, right? A to infinity के लिए आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? आपको इस interval ही ऐसे select करना पड़ेगा, so that you can write it in the form of suppose you are having any set A, which is written as in the union of A to infinity, right? Is it possible for B3? Whether B3 is a base? Yes. Can anyone tell me whether B3 is a base? Okay, this must be homework for you people now, so that you can study what is base and subbase. Okay, you have to verify whether B3 and B4 both are bases for your original topology, or you can say usual topological space, which is given in the exam. Okay, so try to think on this. We'll end the lecture, because for the next one we have to prove one theorem which is related to bases and subbases. Only 3 to 4 theorems are related to subbases and bases. And after that, we will start with TI space nomenclature. Okay. Thank you. You can leave the meeting.